God bless you guys for joining me here at Harvest New Life Studios here at the city of Dallas. Pray that y'all had a beautiful and wonderful and blessed Thanksgiving on yesterday. Spending time with family and friends and just being thankful for what God is doing for us in each one of our lives. I'm truly thankful that God gave me the opportunity to see this day, which I've never seen before, and be able to share time with my family and friends, and knowing that I didn't get a chance to be out there in the area of Michigan as I wanted to be with my mother, but I did share time with my wife and her family, and we had a beautiful time, made contact with my people back home, but it's nothing like being in the presence of them as we get ready to go forth on our service on the day. I want you guys to pay attention to the ear and what the Word of God has to say that's coming from the kingdom of God. We're going to be dealing in the book of John, dealing with the area of the true vine. The process, I want you guys to know about our actual pastoral alliances is already actually going. Got a few good pastors in the city of Dallas, as well as some of our actual international pastors who joined us on this actual pastoral alliance program that we have that's going to be coming up here in January the 1st. It's going to be dealing with really multiple pastors who's going to be speaking and teaching every Friday night from different remote locations, as well as from India, whether from Uganda, and all the different surrounding areas in the state of U.S. I just want you guys to be a part of that program. We'll be posting more information about that program that's coming forth. I think it's something truly God has brought forth, this alliance. It's something that's really needed in the body of Christ as we come together to be as one and do the work of the kingdom of God. But I want you guys to know that, hey, we love you. And we'll get started here in just a moment. But we're going to let the music go ahead and solidify itself, and we're going to move forward after that. God bless.
Glory and the lifter of my very early age. Yes, I've known him nearly all of my life. Well, I admit there have been times when I faltered along the way, but I'll keep trying because somehow I've got to make it in. You see, I've got a charge on my life, and I've got a job to do, and I can't stop until it's through, 'cause I'm determined. Criticizing someone else, there are some things I'd rather leave behind, and another thing, and I don't have time to be bothered with he said, that she said, that they said, because it's all I can do to keep my own self in line. Oh no, work while it's day, 'cause I know the night is surely coming. I'm going all the way.
I'm determined,
because somehow I've got a job to do, and I can't stop until.
Father God, it's such a blessing, such an honor to be in your presence on this morning. It's a day which we have never seen before. It's such a grateful opportunity as you bring us through the actual Thanksgiving season. Being thankful for all the things you have done in our life. And even as I begin to read back over the scriptures, even in the midst of Paul being in his imprisonment, writing the word to you in his heart, making melodies and songs, even in the midst of his state, he still reached out to you, asking you thanks that in the midst of his encapsulation. But Father God, we thank you, Father God, for everything that we have designed and everything we have put on ourselves, but yet still you have delivered us from those things. And Father God, even in the midst of our proclivities, in the midst of some of our mistakes, Father God, you yet seen fit to rise us up another morning to see another day which we have never seen before. Father God, even as I send word out to that area of Michigan, Father God, where my mother and my sisters and brothers are in position on this particular day, Father God, the day after thanks, Father God, let them realize and understand you labored us to see much another day which we have never seen before. Father God, I'm thankful for my wife, for my daughter, for all my children. Father God, that you gave them an opportunity to rise up, Father God, and still have the health in their bodies, to know and declare and decree that you're God, and besides you, there's no other. Father God, I thank you for every opportunity you have given me, Father God, to be in the position I am in right now, for my health, for my strength, for my right mind, and just to decree and declare to know that you're God, and besides you, there's no other. Father God, is such a magnificent, such extraordinary, precious gift you've given us, Father God, which is called life. And even in the midst of our complaining sometimes, Father God, about other things, you yet still see fit to keep us in the land of the living. So, Father God, we thank you as we go into our word and declare and decree on this morning, but how you are the true vine, how you actually puts us in a position, Father God, as a representation of the fruit. After you raised from the table, Father God, speaking to your disciples, they looked upon the boles and saw the very fruit of the vine that lies there, Father God. And you made a proclamation according to the power that you would not drink of the vine or eat of the fruit until you come to earth once again. So, Father God, we thank you for giving us the opportunity of what you did on the cross, Father God, dying for the remission of every one of our sins, to be a perpetuation in the gap where it seems like things in our life are just seeming going opposite, seem to go haywire. Yet you saw fit, Father God, to keep us, Father God, to let us know and realize that you are a God, that you don't break your promises, Father God. You say they will not go back void, but your word has got the power to accomplish all that in there. And Father God, we're thankful, so thankful. Even in the midst of everything that goes on around us, Father God, we ask you, Father God, to put your loving arms around us and keep us safe as we move forward throughout the day, Father God, and realize and bless, Father, that it's you, Father God, who kept us all day long, all week long, Father, every minute and every hour. But there's some here in the world, Father God, who's not going to be able to see the next hour. But Father God, we send forth the mercy and the grace, just as the centurion soldier did in the midst of his sickness of his very fellow servant. So, Father God, we thank you for this opportunity, Father God. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, Lord, we decree the word, we declare. We speak it according to your precious and your power, your precious power. And we realize and understand that you're God, and beside you, there's no other. Father God, we ask you, we thank you for all the blessings that you let us receive this morning. Not only Thanksgiving, but every morning you wake us up all throughout the entirety of our life. Father God, you woke us up and you kept us, Father God. You aim us to continue to be in the land of the living to see this day, Father God, and we may give you thanks in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Lord, I pray, Lord, amen, amen, and amen. You know, it's always great for you guys to be with me on the show. You know, we took a little time back on the actual show, and wasn't broadcasting a lot here in the States, but we've been sending out a lot of our messages for those of you who have been listening on the actual archives and listening to some of the messages that we've actually been sending out over the foreign nations. We've been doing a lot of foreign broadcasts. We've been getting a lot of a lot of response from the foreigner area. And in the U.S. is great, and this is why I live. But most of our pickups and a lot of our information has been coming from our foreign countries, as well as some of those in here in the United States. Not putting anything back, but the majority of most of our calls and most of our show participation has been out in some of our foreign areas. And we thank God for all those who've been with us here in the States and promoting us and helping us to continue to move forth. Even in the midst of what seems to be a proclivity, Father God is yet pulling us out of what we call orange cones, ditches, all those different crossroads that we seem to run into. He's yet still holding us in a position that we need to be in as we go forth and do just what he called us to do. Well, we're going to turn our Bibles. We're going to look over in the book of John, chapter 15. Such a extraordinary vision about when you just parallel some of the micros of these scriptures along with some of the other reading events that we see over in the Bible. And as the Word of God declares, when you get your pens and your pencils together, I want you guys to really catch some good information on this, because it's not going to come from what you call your typical theological teaching. As you look at a book and you get some of what we call man-made teaching, you know, Pastor Ellis teaches through the Spirit. It gives you revelation. It's more or less God gives me the parables, be able to break and see things other than what men's fundamentals from the historical point of view has taught them. But God needs to get us a revelation. It's amazing when we think about the scriptures, we argue the branches of scripture for what men's wrote. Now, the word